Hi children, good morning. 4th class CVS, page 211. Our 19th lesson is about matter and materials. So what is matter? Matter is anything that has mass and occupies space. Air around us is also matter. Matter is made up of tiny particles called molecules. Molecules are so small that they cannot be seen with the naked eye. In nature, matter occurs in three states: solids, liquids and gases. Okay children, the substance which have mass means which has weight and which can occupy space, that is called as the matter. How is matter made up of? Very small particles called as molecules. Molecules together form the matter. Okay, and these cannot be seen with our naked eye, means with our direct with our eyes we cannot see. Only with the help of the microscope only we can see them. And in how many states matter exists? Three states. One is solids, liquids and gases. In solids, molecules will be very closely packed in this way. See here, these are molecules. Okay, they will be packed very closely or tightly. And the space between the molecules, see, these are molecules, no? So in between these molecules we have some space, no? These spaces are called as intermolecular spaces. What they are called as? Intermolecular spaces. But in solids we don't have intermolecular spaces. Why? Because they are very closely packed. So because of this closely packed or tightly packing, they will be hard and have a definite shape, a proper shape, and occupy a definite volume. Next, in liquids the molecules are less closely packed. They will be little far away from each other. So there is a little intermolecular spaces. In these liquids the molecules can move, and liquids do not have a definite shape. Liquids means like water, milk, juices. So they do not have a definite shape. They, in whichever container we pour them, they take that shape of that container. But they occupy a definite space. Next is about the gases. In gases, the molecules are loosely packed. They will be very far away from each other and they can move freely around. And they do not have a definite shape. Gases will not have any definite shape, or they do not occupy a definite space. Because of large intermolecular space, as they are very far away from each other, they can expand and can be compressed easily. Means expand means they can spread, and compressed means very making it closer. Okay, our LPG cylinders contain highly compressed gas. LPG cylinders in cooking, in kitchens we use kitchen cylinders, no? They are called as LPG cylinders. They have compressed gas. And you know, water can occur in all the three states: in solid state, liquid state and gas. In solid state means ice is the solid state, water is the liquid state, and water vapor is the gaseous state. So when we heat ice, what happens? It becomes a water. And if you continue heating the water, it becomes into vapor. And when vapor cools, what happens? It turns into water. And water, when you freeze them, it becomes ice. Okay. So wax also changes from solid to liquid wax on heating. When liquid wax is cooled, it becomes solid wax again. You know, the wax candle, when you light the candle, what happens? By the heat of this, it gets melted. Okay, it turns into liquid, and again when it's cool, when it gets cooled, again it changes into the solid wax. Okay. Here we have given some differences between solids, liquids and gases. In solids, molecules will be very closely packed. In liquids, less closely packed. And in gases, they are loosely packed. In solids, there will be no intermolecular spaces. In liquids, little intermolecular spaces can be found, and in gases, lot of molecular spaces. Solids has a definite shape. Liquids do not have the definite shape. They take the shape of the container. Gases also don't have any definite shape. In whichever we fill the gas, it take the shape of that container. For example, if you blow air into a round balloon, it takes the shape of the round. And if you blow air into other shaped balloon like heart shape, we can find different shapes balloon. No? When you blow air, what happens? They take the shape of that balloon. And so, solids occupies a definite space, a definite volume. Liquids also occupies a definite space. Gases does not occupy a definite space because they can expand and compress easily. Okay children, this is our lesson reading. Now we shall write the question answers of this lesson. In the page number 214, we have fill in the blanks, true or false also. So first we will see the fill in the blanks. Matter is made up of tiny particles called molecules. Matter has mass and occupies space. Molecules in air are loosely packed. Gases and liquids have no definite shape. Solid wax on heating becomes liquid wax. Now write true or false. Correct the false statement. Air around us is not matter. It is false. What is the correct statement? Air around us is also matter. Solids are soft. False. Correct statement is solids are hard. Liquids take the shape of their container. True. Gases cannot be compressed. False. Gases can be compressed. Water on cooling becomes water vapor. False. Water on heating becomes water vapor. Now question answers of this lesson. Page 214. First question. What is matter? What is it made up of? First point. What matter is anything that has mass and occupies space. Second point. Matter is made up of tiny particles called molecules. Second question, how are molecules in a solid arranged? What are the properties of solids? Answer, first point, the molecules in a solid are very closely or tightly packed. There are no intermolecular spaces. Solids are hard, have a definite shape and occupy a definite volume. Next question, what is the difference between the arrangement of molecules in a liquid and a gas? Answer, the molecules in a liquid are less closely packed, whereas the molecules in a gas are loosely packed. Fourth question, why do you think gases can expand and can be compressed easily? Gases can expand and be compressed easily because of large intermolecular spaces. Explain how water changes from one state to another. Ice on heating becomes water and water on heating becomes vapor. Vapor when cooled becomes water. Water when frozen becomes ice. Give any two differences between solids, liquids and gases. Okay, make a table like this, solid, liquid and gases. First point, molecules are very closely packed in solids. Under liquids, you write molecules are less closely packed. Under gases, you write molecules are loosely packed. Now, second point, under the solids, you write no intermolecular spaces. In liquids, little intermolecular spaces. And in gases, lots of intermolecular spaces. Okay children, this is our 19th lesson. Once go through the lesson reading and complete the notes. Okay, have a nice day.